महेश बी कूट एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस थर्ड लेसन ऑफ द कोर्स अल्कोहल फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर्स. इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग फिनॉल्स. व्हाट आर फिनॉल्स, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फिनॉल्स एंड मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ फिनॉल्स. सो लेट अस बिगिन. फिनॉल्स. फिनॉल्स आर द हाइड्रोक्सी डेरिवेटिव्स ऑफ अरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स विथ OH ग्रुप विच इज डायरेक्टली अटैच्ड टू बेंजीन रिंग. सो हाइड्रोक्सी डेरिवेटिव दैट मीन्स OH ग्रुप मस्ट बी प्रेजेंट. अरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स दैट मीन्स एनी बेंजीन रिंग मस्ट बी प्रेजेंट एंड OH इज डायरेक्टली अटैच्ड टू बेंजीन रिंग. So such a compounds are called phenols. So this means phenol contains OH group attached to benzene ring, right? So this is a first member of phenol, nothing but benzene with OH, that is phenol. Second example, benzene with two OH groups, that is called 1,2 dihydroxy benzene. This is also a family of phenol only, because here also OH is attached to benzene ring. Both the OH are attached to benzene ring. And first position, second position, we are having OH group. Therefore, this is called 1,2 dihydroxy benzene. Now, let us start classification of phenols. Classification of phenols. First one, monohydric phenols. Look at the name, mono. Mono means one, right? Monohydric, one OH group. So monohydric phenols are the phenols which contain one hydroxyl group directly attached to benzene in their structure. So this is called monohydric phenols that contains one hydroxyl group and directly attached to benzene ring. In monohydric phenol, first member is a phenol itself. Only one OH group is directly attached to this benzene ring. That is called phenol. Second example, 2-methyl phenol. Why it is a 2-methyl phenol, guys? So this is a first position, this is a second position. In second position, we are having methyl group. So this is our phenol ring. This is methyl group. Methyl group is present at second position. Therefore, this is called 2-methyl phenol. First, second. Second position, methyl group. This is called 2-methyl phenol. Third example, 3-methyl phenol. So carefully see here, guys. 1, 2, 3. So, third position, there is a methyl group. This is our phenol ring. This is a methyl group at the third position. So therefore, the name 3-methyl phenol. Next one example is 4-methyl phenol. That means starting from this OH group, 1, 2, 3, 4. So fourth position, there is a methyl group. So this is a phenol ring. Fourth position, there is a methyl group. Therefore, this is called 4-methyl phenol. So in all these examples, we are observing only one OH. Yes, one OH directly attached to benzene ring. Therefore, these are called monohydric phenols. These are called monohydric phenols. Now come to the next one, that is dihydric phenols. So again look at the name. Di means two. Hydric means OH group. So two OH groups are present here. So these compounds contain two OH groups directly attached to benzene in their structure. So carefully see here, guys. This is our benzene ring. This is one OH group. This is second OH group. So that means dihydric phenol contains two OH groups directly attached to benzene ring. So what is the name of this one? Benzene 1,2-diol. Why diol? Two OH group. Why all? Suffix for alcoholic functional group is all. So first and second position we are having alcoholic group and this is a benzene ring. Therefore the name benzene 1,2-diol. Second example, carefully see here, 1, 2, 3. So third position and first position, we are having OH groups. So this is a benzene ring. So therefore, this is called benzene 1,3-diol. Why 1,3? Because first and third position, we are having OH groups. Therefore, this is called benzene 1,3-diol. Next example, benzene 1,4-diol. First position, fourth position. We are having OH groups. Therefore, this is called benzene 1,4-diol. Why benzene? Benzene ring is there. Why 1,4? Because first and fourth position we are having OH group. Why diol? Two OH groups are there. And for alcoholic functional group, we are providing suffix as a all. So in all these examples, we are having two OH groups. Yes, we are having two OH groups, guys. Therefore, these all examples are comes under dihydric phenols. Third one, trihydric phenols. So tri means three, hydric means OH. So three OH groups are there here. Carefully see here, they contain three OH groups directly attached to benzene ring in their structure. So in all these examples, carefully see OH, OH, OH. So here also three OH groups are there. Here also we are getting three OH groups. So in all the example, three OH groups are there. Therefore, these are called trihydric phenol. So what is the name of first one? Benzene 1,2,3-triol. This indicates on benzene, first position, second position and third position, there are three OH groups are there. Therefore, triol, tri for three, all for OH groups. Benzene 1,2,3-triol. Same way, second one, 1,2,3,4. That means 1,2,4. Benzene 1,2,4-triol. Similarly here, 1,2,3,4,5. So benzene 1,3,5-triol. So these all examples are comes under trihydric phenol. Next one, method of preparation of phenol. First method is from benzene sulfonic acid. First we should prepare benzene sulfonic acid. From the benzene sulfonic acid, we are going to get the phenol. Okay, how to prepare benzene sulfonic acid? Take a benzene, add fuming sulfuric acid at 80 degree Celsius temperature. What this H2SO4 is there now? In H2SO4, HSO3 is attached here to the benzene ring. So this one is called benzene sulfonic acid. So first we have prepared the benzene sulfonic acid. From that we have to prepare the phenol. So to prepare phenol from the benzene sulfonic acid, we must proceed through these steps. First one, benzene sulfonic acid when treated with NaOH. NaOH means any strong base. We are getting sodium benzene sulfonate. That means OH of the NaOH and H of the SO3 eliminated as a H2O. Minus H2O is eliminated and forming this Na with this oxygen bond. That is sodium benzene sulfonate is formed. This is a salt. When this sodium benzene sulfonate is treated with again some base with 300 degree Celsius temperature, we are getting sodium finnate. This is again a salt of phenol. Sodium finnate, phenol with oxygen carrying minus charge and sodium carrying plus charge. This is called sodium finnate. When this sodium finnate on treating with HCl, we are getting phenol. So this is a process to prepare phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. I hope you understood. Second method, from diazonium salt. Di for 2, azo for nitrogen. So here 2 nitrogens are attached and salt is there because plus and minus charge both are there on the same compound. So diazonium salt is formed by treating aniline with nitrous acid. Nitrous acid is HNO2, that is formed in situ, in reaction media itself. NaNO2 and HCl, if you add that one, we are getting HNO2, that is a nitrous acid, which on warming, phenol is formed. So this is aniline. Aniline means benzene with NH2. NaNO2 and HCl is nothing but nitrous acid, HNO2 we are getting. At 0 to 5 degree, that means colder condition is required here. Benzene diazonium salt is formed. Why it is benzene diazonium? This is a benzene ring. Diazo for 2N2, chloride for Cl-. So totally benzene diazonium chloride. When this benzene diazonium chloride is hydrolyzed, we are getting phenol and N2 liberation. So this is from preparation of phenol from aniline or preparation of phenol from benzene diazonium chloride. Now next one, that is nothing but from cumene. To prepare the phenol from cumene, we first prepare the cumene. So cumene nothing but isopropyl benzene. So propane with second position attached, that is called isopropyl benzene. So cumene is obtained by heating benzene with propene at 250 degrees Celsius in presence of phosphoric acid catalyst. So benzene treated with the propene, we in presence of phosphorus acid, we are getting cumene. Nothing but, so this double bond breaks and this H is attached to this. We are getting isopropyl benzene, that is nothing but commonly called cumene. Now we prepared a cumene. From cumene, we have to prepare the phenol. So to do this process, again several steps are there. When cumene is oxidized in presence of O2, air, to form cumene hydroperoxide. This is our cumene hydroperoxide, which on hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis, yield phenol and acetone. Carefully see here guys, this is a cumene, isopropyl benzene is called a cumene. When we add O, that is O2, so this O2 is inserted here, so we are getting this one, nothing but cumene hydroperoxide. Why cumene hydroperoxide? 2O groups are attached to the cumene, inserted in the cumene. Next, when we do acid hydrolysis, we are getting acetone. How this acetone is formed? So carefully look here, blue color, CH3, CCH3, and this H is formed as a acetone and this O, and remaining with this oxygen and one H from here. So we are getting phenol and acetone. So next method, from halorins. When chlorobenzene is heated with NaOH solution at 350 degrees Celsius in presence of copper as a catalyst, acidification gives phenol. First we should do chlorobenzene treated with sodium. What is that? NaOH means sodium hydroxide at 350 degrees Celsius and 300 atmospheric pressure in presence of copper as a catalyst. We are getting sodium phenate and HCl. So which on added HCl, we are getting phenol. So how this reaction is proceed from chlorobenzene to phenol? Carefully see here, when we add chlorobenzene to sodium hydroxide, whatever red color you are observing, HCl is eliminated. What is eliminated? HCl, and this ONa is bonded to this carbon atom. Carefully see here. When we got the sodium phenate, to that we have to add the HCl. If you add an HCl, again, any acid we add, NaCl is eliminated, whatever blue color you are observing, and this H is added to this oxygen, forming phenol, and NaCl is eliminated from chlorobenzene to phenol. I hope you understood. So this is regarding this session, guys. Thank you. Thanks for